finite and infinite sets. First, we will see what is finite. A set in which the process of counting of elements surely comes to an end. So whenever we are able to count the set, there is nothing but finite set. This finite set has a countable number of elements. Okay, infinite is we can't count, or you know it directly. So let me give an example also. First, if you see finite set, so we can define mainly like this. When you are counting, the process of counting of elements surely comes to an end. So while you are counting, there is supposed to be end. Okay, for example, set of all the prime numbers less than 100. So we can count it. Set of all the natural numbers less than 1000. So we can count it, right? So these are all the finite sets. So countable, which are countable, then nothing but finite set. Set of all prime numbers less than 1000. So before less than 1000, we can count all the prime numbers how many are, and we can write in any form, either set builder form or roster form also. X such that x belongs to integers and x is a factor. X is factor of 10,000. So 10,000 is a big number, but we can find out all the factors of 10,000 also, which are belongs to only integers. So these are we can countable. And x such that x belongs to natural number and x is less than 1000. Any number. Now this is, for example, instance hundreds, thousands and 50 millions. So less than this number we can count everything. And one special note in this finite sets, sometimes we cannot count the objects of finite set, but we know the counting process will surely come to an end. So like that examples also I'll give you. Set of all persons, set of all persons on the earth. So it's impossible, but there is a chance of getting till end, last person also we can count. Okay, sometimes we cannot count the object directly, but surely will come to an end by counting. So even this also is an example for finite set only. And set of all the trees on the earth, or set of all the trains, set of all trains on the earth. So like these examples also will come under finite set. So which are whatever it is, which are able to count, they are nothing but finite set, or which are countable. Right, now we'll see infinite set. So it just reverse for finite, just infinite. A set which consists of an uncountable number of distinct elements is called an infinite set. Okay, uncountable and distinct elements, the both words, uncountable and distinct elements. A set which is consists of uncountable numbers of distinct elements, or distinct elements, we can say that is a infinite set. So we'll keep on counting also, we'll never come to an end. This is nothing but uncountable. Okay, for example, set of all natural numbers. Set of all natural number. So natural number will begin with 1, but there's no end. For example, if I take 10,000 is the last number, next 10,001. 1 crore is last number, next 1 crore and 1. So like this, there's no end for it. So these are all infinite sets. X belongs to integer and x is less than 10. So less than 10 is 9, 8, even 0, next minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 till ending, negative infinites. So there are endless. These are nothing but infinite sets. Set of all concentric circles with a given center. Set of all concentric circles with a given center. For example, this is center. With center, I can draw one circle. Now, with this center, we can draw one more circle. So, with this center, we can draw. There are uncountable circles we can draw. So, this is also an example for infinite sets. This is concentric. Concentric means same center. The circles which are drawn, same center is nothing but concentric. We can draw infinite circles. So, there is an infinite set. So, like many examples are there. These are the few examples from infinite set. You will see what is a cardinal number of a finite set. Cardinal number of a finite set. So this cardinal number is the cardinal number of a finite set. So finite set is nothing but they are countable. So we can count it. So the number of distinct elements obtained in the finite set is called cardinal number of set. So we need to count how many are there. For example, if you take set A, 1, 2, 3, 7, 10, 15. Now this I am taking set A. Set A is 1, 2, 3, 7, 10, 15. Now number of elements in set A is nothing but cardinal number of the set. So how many are there here? 6 are there. So n of A is equal to 6. So we can denote with n of A. So that is nothing but cardinal number. So number of elements in a particular set is nothing but cardinal number. So repetition of number is meaningless. So we should not repeat any element within the set. So there is no repetition. Distinct elements only we need to count. That only we can treat as a set. Then for example, if B is a set, I am taking X such that X is letter. X is a letter in the word mathematics. So there are some repetition in this. That's what I said before. So we should not take the repeat. Now that is M, comma A, comma T. H E I C S. All these are the letters. Okay, some letters are repeated. Here T is repeated 2 times. So some letters are repeated. So we should not take the repeated letters. So N of B. It is cardinal number of this particular set B. So we can take number of letters is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Counting number of elements in a particular finite set is nothing but cardinal number of set. Now what is a empty set? So in the name of this word, here only you have the meaning. Empty set. A set consisting of no elements at all is called an empty set. So if there is no any element in the set, it is nothing but empty set. For example, so generally empty set, or you can treat as null set. So there is no any element at all in the set, then nothing but empty set. So we will denote it by this as pi, this is a symbol. We can denote the empty set with pi, pi, phai, we have to call it as pi. So how we can denote this clearly? For example, I will give you first. Now x such that x belongs to natural number, one less than x less than 2. So is there any number between 1 and 2? The 2 particular natural number. Now this is a null set. Now this is empty set because there is no any element. Right? Otherwise x is a even prime greater than 5. So is any even prime number greater than 5? Any even prime number which is greater than 5? So no. So there is no any element by satisfying this condition. So that's why that set we can call it as a null set or empty set. So we can sometimes you can call void. Yeah, we can treat as void set also. These are all the names: null set, void set, or empty set. If there is no any element at all in particular set by satisfying the particular condition, then there is nothing but null set. We can denote with this symbol pi. And non-empty set is just reverse. Non-empty set means at least if there is one element is called non-empty set. Right? If you understand empty set, it's non-empty easy. So non-empty set, a set which has at least one element. Is at least one element also, then that is non-empty set. In any particular set, if there is at least one element, that is a non-empty set. Next, singleton set. So non-empty means not only one, you can take more than one also. Now next is a singleton set. Singleton set. In this word only there is a meaning, is a set containing exactly one element is called a singleton set. So exactly only one element in particular set, exactly one element is there, then it's nothing but singleton set. So even primes is a singleton set because even prime is only 2. Okay, 2 is the only even prime, so there is a singleton set. Otherwise, a set A, we can denote x such that 3x minus 6 is equal to 0. So 3x minus 6 is equal to 0 means 3x is equal to 6. Okay, if you solve this, 3x is equal to 6 and x is equal to 2. Finally, this set is only 2. Okay. So even prime also only 2. and x is a month having less than 30 days. The month which is having less than 30 days is February. Set C. So we can denote a particular month less than 30 days. So less than 30 days is that only singleton, that is only February month. So these are the singleton sets. We can denote if there is only single, exactly one element, there is nothing but singleton set. Okay, now let us see equal sets. Equal sets and equivalent sets. So there is a meaning. Explain now. Equal sets. Okay, first we let us discuss about equal sets. So we know the meaning equal means should be same. That means two sets A and B are said to be equal, written as A is equal to B. If every element of A is in B and every element of B also is in A. Okay, A is one set and B is one set. Every element of A should be in B and every element of B also should be in A. There is a condition. For example, A is having 1, 3, 5 and B is having 3, 5, 1. Now we can say A is a set and B is a set. The both are equal. So they are equal sets. So every element of A should be in B and every element of B also should be in A. Then only we can treat as A is equal to B. So A and B are equal sets. So an example, I'll give one more. Okay, let P is a set X such that X is a letter in the word. X is letter in the word follow. F-O-L-L-O-W. So X is a letter in the word follow. And set Q. Set Q is also one more. X is a letter in the word wolf, W-O-L-F. Now if you observe carefully, they are given in tabular form. Both if you write in roster form. So P is equals to all the letters in the follow. They are F, comma, O, comma, L, comma, W. Now next to Q also we write W, O, L and F. So same letters in P and Q. Therefore, we can say the P is equals to Q. So P set and Q set are equal sets. There is nothing but equal sets. Now we'll see equivalent set. Previous we have seen equal sets. EQI. Equivalent sets. So see here, this is equivalent. Equal set means every element of A should be in B and every element of B should be in A. They're equal. But when you come to equivalent, two finite sets A and B are said to be equivalent, and we can written as A is equivalent to B. Only condition is the cardinal number of A and B must be same. That means number of elements A should be equal to number of elements in B. Whatever elements, their number should be same. Okay, for example, A is having letter A, B, C, D, and B is a set 1, 2, 3, 4. So cardinal number of A, that is n of A, is equals to 4, because there are 4 elements, and n of B is equals to also 4. So there are 4 elements. Therefore, n of A is equals to n of B. Then A is equivalent to B. Right? So this is the symbol. This symbol for equivalent. Only the number of elements should be same. Whatever the elements are there, but there should be number of elements. Equal number of elements should be in both sets. Then we can say they are equivalent. Okay, here is an important note, right? So we have seen equal sets and equivalent, right? Two equal sets are always equivalent. Any two equal sets, if you take any two equal sets, are always equivalent. This we know because elements also same means surely number of elements are same. But two equivalent sets need not be equal. Okay, equivalent sets need not be equal always, but every equal sets are always equivalent. So okay, these are the conditions. Two equal sets are always equivalent, but equivalent need not be equal. Okay, now previous you have seen two equal sets, so they are nothing but equivalent, but equivalent need not be equal always. Example given same previous set A is 1 2 3, set B is 3 2 1. Now set A and set B are equal. Set A is equal to B. At the same time A is equivalent to B also, but in case numbers are elements are different, they are not equal but they are equivalent. Okay, these are the conditions to represent either they are equal or equivalent. So this is the information up to sets and type of sets. Next we will see subsets, and we will discuss more on subsets also now.